Another important flow property is called the circulation, which is related to vorticity. In fact, so the circulation is a scalar, and we're going to call it gamma, and it's equal to the negative of the surface integral of the vorticity, which, remember, vorticity, omega, is del cross v. It's the curl of the velocity vector. So it's del cross v dotted with the local normal and integrated over the surface. So let's look at what this might look like on a three-dimensional surface. So let's say we have some three-dimensional surface here in space, and it has some velocity field throughout. And we're just going to take one little chunk of that, and we'll call that ds. So this is ds. And at ds, we have a couple different vectors we're interested in. One of them is the normal. So that's the normal vector to that surface. And then we also are interested in del cross v, which is a which is the vorticity there. So del cross v. So if we were to integrate this over the whole surface, we would have the integral basically of the vorticity dotted with the local normal, and that's equal to what's called the circulation. Now, there's a theorem by Stokes called Stokes' theorem that says that this can that the surface integral is or can be written as a line integral, and so this is actually equal to the line integral over some closed surface of v, the velocity vector, dotted with d, and this is a little s. So the enclosed surface here is this right here. That's the enclosed surface, and ds, the d little s vector, is this vector that is tangent at each point to the surface. So we can integrate around this closed surface and look at just the velocity that is touching the surface and dot it with the local ds, because at each point here we've got the ds, and we also have a local velocity. And so we can integrate that around the surface. And that is equivalent to the integral of the curl of the velocity over the entire surface. Anyway, either way we do this, what we get out is the circulation. Now, if we were to integrate either of these right now, according to the right-handed rule, if we got out something that went in the counterclockwise direction, that would be positive according to the right-handed rule. But circulation is positive in the clockwise direction, not counterclockwise direction. So that's why we have the negative here out in front of both of these, because it's actually opposite of the right-hand rule. But that's how the circulation is defined. So let's see why we care about this. Let's start off with a simple example where we have just uniform flow in space, and we want to understand what the circulation is in that flow. Well, we can draw a circle or some shape through that flow and integrate around that. So with this particular flow that I've shown here, let's look at let's walk around this with ds, where that's my ds vector. Now, at the top, ds is going to be in the opposite direction of the local velocity vector, and so that's going to give us a negative value there for the circulation. At the bottom, the local velocity vector is in the same direction as ds, and so that's going to give us a positive. And And it turns out that this now will integrate to zero independent of the path that I take around this this uniform flow. And I could have taken a perfect circle throughout that flow or some, you know, kind of any shape that I wanted, as long as that's a closed surface, and it would have produced zero. So gamma for this is equal to zero. So let's look at an airfoil and look at some streamlines that would surround that airfoil. Okay, so there's my airfoil and there's some streamlines around it. Now again, we can take, and I'll put this in a different color, we can take some closed path around that airfoil and integrate with ds. Again, ds is tangent at every point along that path. And so as I integrate around, again, I'm going to get a negative along the top because ds is in the opposite direction of the velocity, and a positive at the bottom because it's in the same direction as the velocity. Now, I haven't drawn these streamlines really well, but what you could see from the streamlines, if they were really well drawn, is that the velocity at the top of the airfoil is going faster than the velocity below the airfoil. And you'd be able to see that from the streamlines because the streamlines at the top should actually be closer together than the streamlines at the bottom. Because of that, the negative component here is going to be greater than the positive component. And so gamma will be positive because it's actually the negative. Remember, if we come back up here, we have this negative sign out front. So once we do that line integral, we flip the sign. And so that gives us a positive circulation around an airfoil. And that's going to become really important because circulation is actually related to lift. And we'll go into that in more detail later. Now, there's another thing I want to point out here. And that is that if I had not surrounded the airfoil with my cut here. So let's take a different cut and let's go out here. Or we could actually go at any point in the flow that does not include the airfoil. It turns out that the circulation here is zero for an irrotational flow. So for irrotational flow, gamma equals zero. And that's true at every point in the flow. Irrotational flow is where the vorticity is zero. So del cross V equals zero. And so since the circulation is the integral of del cross V on this surface, you know, we can think of it either way. We can either do the line integral around the outside, and that's this term here that we kind of looked at with these examples here, or we could have integrated del cross V throughout the region, but as if del cross V is zero, then of course that integral goes to zero and the circulation is zero. So there's a special class of flows that are irrotational, and those are actually also potential flows. We'll talk about that more in the coming sections. But that means that at every point in the flow, the vorticity is zero. The curl of the velocity is zero. And so if you do this line integral around this surface, gamma equals zero. Now, it wasn't true in the airfoil case here, because we had an object enclosed in this line integral. And so that's the difference here between the green and the red. The green does not have an object enclosed. And as long as you don't enclose an object in an irrotational flow, the vorticity is equal to zero, or the circulation is equal to zero. But if you have an object enclosed in the flow, then it can be non-zero. And that's the special case we have with airfoils, and we'll learn more about that in coming lectures.